Hello YouTube fam, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Tina and I make videos on lifestyle, home, and DIY projects every single week. Today's video is a little bit different than my typical DIY videos. I know a lot of you guys have been enjoying air-dry clay projects, so for today's video, I wanted to give you guys my best tips and tricks when working with air-dry clay. I've been working with it and experimenting with it for a little over a year now, so although I don't have all the answers, I definitely understand some of the challenges that you guys are having. I compiled all of your frequently asked questions, so hopefully I can answer all of those today and help you guys out when you're working with air-dry clay. Before we jump in, I also want to give Squarespace a huge thank you for sponsoring today's video. I will talk a little bit more about them later. I hope you guys are ready to dive into all these tips and tricks, so let's go ahead and get started with the projects. Hello from VoiceOver Tina. The air dry clay that I'm using today is the Crayola brand one, and I just like this one because it's widely available at craft stores and online, and I get a 5-pound tub for about $10, so it's also pretty affordable. I also love that it comes in an airtight container, which helps make it last much longer so I don't have to worry about wrapping it or putting it into a separate container when I'm done using it. To start, here are the tools and materials that I like using best when it comes to working with air-dry clay. First is a rolling pin or anything that is cylindrical to help you roll out your clay to create some slabs. If you've been following me for a while, you know there was a point when I was using a soda can, so just use what you have at home. Next, I would highly suggest getting a small precision knife like an X-Acto knife. This is super handy to cut out your clay and also to use to score your clay. Along with that, I always like to have a straight edge handy, so I use a plastic ruler like this one. I would also suggest using wax paper underneath your clay project so that you have a smooth and clean surface to work on. And if you want to get fancy, you can also use a silicone mat for maximum durability. When it comes to other tools, wooden and metal clay tools are definitely nice to have, but not necessarily a must-have. There are definitely advantages to using these to create more complex pieces, so if you want to level up your clay DIYs, I would definitely recommend getting a small kit like this one. But honestly, your number one tools are always going to be your hands. You don't need anything fancy to get started. All the materials I talked about are great to have, but you definitely don't need them to create something beautiful. Next, I wanted to talk about slip, which is a clay and water mixture, and you essentially use this as a glue to adhere your clay pieces together. And one of the most frequently asked questions is how to make slip, and really it's up to you on the consistency of your slip. Generally, I like to use a 3-to-1 ratio of clay to water when I want to adhere two pieces together. Essentially, you want to make a slurry of the clay and water to create a heavy whipping cream consistency. I also like to use the top of a slip mixture where it's most watery to create a gloss on top of the surface to smooth everything out. I wanted to quickly talk about some basic hand building techniques so that you guys are familiar with these terms. So the first one is slab building, and you're essentially just rolling out your clay into flat pieces and using those to build your piece. Next is coiling, which is rolling out small log-shaped pieces into long coils, and this is great for building things like pots and bowls. And lastly, we have pinching, which is essentially using a lump of clay to pinch it into your desired forms. So those are the basic techniques that I'm using to create the projects in today's video. Each of these projects are pretty simple, so I'm gonna work on these while answering some of these FAQs. All right, now that we have the basics down, I'm going to create a trinket dish to help go over some of the most frequently asked questions through each step of creating projects with air-dry clay. Trinket dishes are a great beginner-friendly project, but if you're more advanced, you can totally use some of these tips and techniques that I'm covering too. First, I'm rolling out a slab to create our dish, and one of the best tricks to create an even slab is to put wooden pieces on both sides at the desired length. I like to use popsicle sticks since this is a simple and affordable option, and for my dish, I stacked 5 on top of each other. One of the biggest questions when it comes to working with air-dry clay is how to avoid getting cracks, so I'm going to give you guys a bunch of different tips sprinkled throughout this project since there are so many things that you can do to avoid this. One of the first ways is to avoid creating pieces that are too thin because they are easier to crack, and generally, you want your pieces to be more than a 1/4 inch thick. Rolling out clay could lead to creating small air bubbles, so if you encounter any, just pierce the bubble with an X-Acto knife, and when you roll over it again, it will push the bubble out, flattening the clay. Now that it's nice and even, I'm going to use a candle lid to trace out my circle shape. And I'm just using my knife to cut this out, but if you have a cookie cutter, that also works pretty great. I find that using household items like lids and jars as a cutter and pushing it down usually does not work out great, so tracing and cutting it out will do just the trick. To get a lip for a dish, I'm just going to create a coil that will wrap around the entire tray, and I'm going to try to make this as even as possible. As I'm rolling, I'm moving my hands inwards and outwards, and I find that to be the easiest way to create an even coil. Now to attach the two pieces, we're going to do the score and slip technique by creating hatch marks on both the coil and the outer rim of the dish. This creates some rough texture for the clay to grab onto, and you just want to apply some slip to act as glue to bond the two pieces together. I also wanted to add that joints and seams like this one are prone to cracking because they are the most vulnerable areas, so definitely be mindful of that when working on projects with multiple pieces. I always like to take my time to smooth out the edges to create a strong bond, so you'll see that I'm gradually adding more slip and water to smooth everything out and also blending the two edges together as best as I can. I find that when working on more detailed projects, using a wooden tool like this one really helps, but you could also use things like popsicle sticks or whatever you have at home to blend in tiny edges like this one. Okay, so I'm very happy with how this one's looking, so I'm just going to set it aside while I work on the cactus. First, I'm going to create a small coil, which is going to be the main body of the cactus, and I want it to be tapered so that one end is a little bit bigger, and this kind of reminds me of a unicorn horn. As I'm going along, I add some slip, and this is just going to smooth everything out and cover any creases on the clay. Then I'm just going to cut one end of it to my desired length, and I'm just going to let that sit on the side to harden while I work on the arms. So for these, I'm shaping them into these little curved coils, and I'm making them a little bit smaller than the main piece. And again, I'm smoothing it out as I go, but we are going to come back to it later to completely smooth everything out. And that's one of the nicest things when it comes to working with air dry clay. Unless it has hardened to be completely bone dry, you can still smooth it out later with some water. Even after 12 hours of dry time, I'm able to go back in and smooth out any smaller edges. And this is great because it's also a lot easier to handle when it's hardened a bit more. So I basically let it dry for about 30 minutes, and then I came back to assemble the cactus together. I gauged where I wanted the pieces to be, and then I just cut them to the appropriate length to score and slip onto the cactus. And at this point, it's a lot easier to work with since the clay isn't super soft. I'm able to get in and smooth everything out. And now I'm gonna let that sit for a little bit before I attach it to my dish. Before jumping into the next step, I wanted to quickly talk to you guys about Squarespace, who's sponsoring today's video. As you guys may or may not already know, I'm currently in the process of building out my website, and Squarespace has seriously made it so easy to build a website that I'm really proud of. One of the most important things to me is not to only have a beautiful website, but to also have a very functional website. So they have tons of templates to choose from, and it really caters towards what you're looking for. So whether you're an artist looking to build an online portfolio or an e-commerce brand looking to sell products, Squarespace has all the tools to get you started. And if you guys are anything like me and want to DIY and really customize your website, Squarespace has a library of resources that you guys can turn to. They provide their users with so much great information to use tools like the integrated e-commerce templates, marketing analytics, and email campaigns. So if you guys have been thinking about creating a website for a while, I would definitely recommend that you head on over there to check them out. I think now is the perfect time to build a website, so if you guys are interested in checking them out, make sure that you click on the link down below to get 10% off of your first website or domain. I'm super excited with how my website is coming along, and I hope you guys are too, but for now, let's jump into the next step. Alright, so now it is time to put everything together, and I'm going to score the middle of the dish, and we're also going to score the bottom of the cactus, and then add in some slip to hold it all together. And at this point, I'm really going to take my time to blend the cactus and the dish together to make it look as seamless as possible. So you'll see that I'm using my wooden tool and also some slip, and this works really perfectly. Whenever I work on a project that needs to be turned a lot, I always put it on top of something like a bowl or a dish, and this just adds some height. And this way, I don't have to directly handle the piece, I can just move it around by rotating the bowl instead. This is also a great trick to minimize warping on the bottom, since I also got some questions on that. By doing this, you're keeping the bottom flat and avoiding lifting or moving it around too much to become uneven. So now I'm going to let it dry for about 24 hours, and we will come back to paint it. If you have any dry clay on your table, you can just scrape it and put it into your slip to make even more slip. This is also a great way to reuse any pieces of clay that have dried up in the process so that you're not wasting any clay at all. And I usually store it in a little container that I can use it time after time. And if you don't finish a project all in one day and need more time to work on it, you can totally keep the clay wet by covering it with a damp paper towel and then putting it into a bag or an airtight container, and your clay is ready to be worked on the next day. One of the biggest benefits of using air-dry clay is that you do not need a kiln to fire it like ceramic clay does, so you're able to easily create beautiful pieces in the comfort of your own home. But since you're working in a less controlled environment, there are a few things that you can do to avoid cracks, so I'm gonna go over some tips as well as talk about how to fix them during the drying process. One thing I noticed is that you should not let your clay stick onto a surface that you're working on. Air-dry clay shrinks as it dries, so if it's stuck to a surface like your table, it's going to pull against that surface, causing those cracks. So to avoid this, make sure that you lift your project from the surface so that the air can get to the bottom of the piece and dry it more evenly. Same goes with trying to cover glass or attaching air-dry clay to something else. It's going to crack as it dries since it's dragging onto that surface. And I've actually tried this in the past, and every time it cracks and I realize this is the major reason why. So it's best if you let the clay dry completely and then glue it onto something afterwards. You should also avoid leaving it in a hot area to dry, and I know it's very tempting to let it sit in the sun or even use a hairdryer to dry it faster, but this will actually cause the clay to dry unevenly and could also cause warping to your piece. A great place to dry it is in a warm, clean cupboard or a cabinet, and you can go ahead and turn it time to time to help it dry more evenly. This is also a great time to check on your piece and fix any cracks right before it becomes bone dry. And you can easily do this by adding on slip on top of your small cracks. If you encounter bigger cracks, you can go ahead and glue the two pieces together with the score and slip technique. I've definitely encountered this in the past, so this usually does the trick and you can just smooth out the cracked edge. Air-dry clay can take anywhere between 24 to 48 hours to dry completely, so make sure that it has hardened and become bone dry before moving on to the next step to paint or seal it. You can tell when it's dry when the piece turns a white color and you're ready to go. To add some color to my piece, I'm just using some craft acrylic paint right onto the clay, and I wanted this to have a boho look, so I'm adding some speckling and fun patterns on the base to achieve this. You can also use something like gesso to prime your clay if you want a more even base before you go paint it. My only recommendation with paint is to avoid using a water-activated paint like watercolors or gouache. This will actually wet the surface of the clay again and make it a little bit more muddy, so I usually try to avoid that. And for other options, you can also spray paint this or use latex-based paint as well. Painting it really makes your pieces come to life to add your own personalization, and usually it takes me 2 coats to get even coverage. After everything is dry, you can go ahead and seal it. I'm using a Sculpey gloss glaze for a shiny finish, and I'm gonna give it 2 coats. You can also use an acrylic sealant spray, and I will list a few options as well as all the tools and materials that I used in today's video in the description box. This last step is super important because air-dry clay ultimately is not waterproof, but we can make it water-resistant by using these sealants to make our beautiful air-dry clay pieces last. I hope you guys enjoyed going through this journey of creating my cute cactus ring dish and learned some new tips and tricks for your future air-dry clay projects. Air-dry clay is such a great medium to play around with. It's honestly a stress reliever for me because I find it to be a very therapeutic medium to work with, and it's really amazing all the things that you can create with it, and I'm excited to share even more tips and tricks as I continue making clay DIYs on my channel. So those were all my best tips and tricks when it comes to working with air-dry clay. Let me know in the comments which tip you found to be most helpful. I hope you guys learned something new and can use some of these tricks in your next project. If you have any more questions that I didn't get to in this video, definitely let me know in the comments down below, and hopefully I can do a part 2 to this. If you liked this video and found it to be helpful, make sure that you give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down below for new videos every single week. And don't forget to tag me on Instagram if you recreate any of the projects from today's video or any of my videos. I love all the projects projects that you guys have been sending me in. You guys are seriously so creative. I love that some of you are creating things for your home and trying out new projects for the first time. Some of you are creating DIYs as gifts, which I absolutely love. So please keep them coming. I love to comment and like on every single one of them. Again, a huge thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. If you want to check them out and get 10% off of your first website or domain, make sure that you click on the link down below to get all the details. And that's it for today's video. Thank you guys all so much for watching and for supporting my channel. Stay inspired, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!